I'm Carla Turner with the New Hanover County Health Department. Today I have with me George Gardner and Carl Byrd from the Wilmington Prostate Cancer Support Group. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
We're happy to be here.
Thank you. Very happy to be here.
We're going to talk a little bit about prostate cancer and prostate cancer awareness and screening, so I wanted to ask you some questions. I'll start with you, Mr. Gardner. Why do you think prostate screening is important?
Well, one of the most important reasons is I am a prostate cancer survivor, and so is Carl. So we think it's very important.
Definitely.
Because it allowed us to find out what our status was and determine what kind of treatment we wanted to have, or if any. So screening is extremely important. If one is not screened and an event takes place later in life, if prostate cancer is found, it might not be treatable.
Okay. Mr. Byrd, what are your thoughts on that?
My thoughts are very high on that. Prostate cancer screening is what saved my life. And it was through the PSA that I was determined to be in stage one prostate cancer. And this was after a year with a totally clean physical. So it popped up within 1 year, my numbers had doubled. And I'm blessed to have a very aggressive doctor. And they immediately gave me my options, visit with the urologist and oncologist, and decision made as to how I would treat this.
Okay. So in talking about screening, what would you say to a man around 40 about prostate health and prostate screening? Because it's not something that everybody thinks about having done.
So. Well, I would share, as I have the past year plus that I've been with the Wilmington Prostate Cancer Support Group, is to receive or request a prostate screening, particularly African Americans, men that have any type of cancer in their family, be it on the female side, breast, ovarian, colon, or any type of cancer on the male side, particularly prostate.
Okay, Mr. Gardner?
Well, it's extremely important to have the screening to help identify cancers that can be treated now. Some cancers we might be able to live with for the rest of our lives. But we wouldn't know unless we were screened. So I know there's been a lot of publicity recently about the PSA test and whether it should be given to people over 75 or do we really need it. Well, it's the only test we have. Right. If we don't get that test, we'll never know. And it doesn't have to be some slippery slope, so the minute you get tested and you find something positive, you're down the road to all kinds of treatment. But if you don't know, in this case, what you don't know may hurt you.
Can hurt you. Yeah, well, that's a very good point. And I think I heard both of you saying that it isn't just men 40 and over, that if you said if you have a positive family history, you really need to talk to your physician, even at younger than 40, about the need for that type of screening.
Certainly.
It can be done.
Certainly.
Okay.
And we're real pleased that local organizations step up to offer screening to men who happen to have no health insurance or some factor that keeps them from getting screened. But the state of North Carolina has a law that says that PSA tests are supposed to be allowed on all insurances. So if you have health insurance, you can get screened for prostate cancer. And it's also a prostate health screening as well. There are other things that the urologist can find out about you, or your general physician. So screening is extremely important for prostate health, including prostate cancer.
Okay.
And again, if you've got cancer in your family, that's more of a reason to request a prostate screening.
Okay. Tell me a little bit about your support group.
Carl has been very enthusiastic about our support group. I'm gonna let him expand on this. But the Wilmington Prostate Cancer Support Group is a chapter of Us Two International.
Okay.
But the important thing is that we've been around about 15 to 18 years. We meet monthly. Anyone who has questions about prostate cancer or PSA testing or anything like that can come to the meetings. Anyone who's been told that they have a problem with PSA or they've been diagnosed, it's always best to come to a group of guys who've had almost every kind of treatment and can offer them some advice. There's an old Chinese proverb, if you want to know what's on the road up ahead, ask the man coming back.
That's a very good thought.
It's a good opportunity if you have any questions, particularly in this time of some confusion about PSA testing and all. Come and talk to some people who've had that experience and can assist you in helping make a decision about whether you should be tested or not. But of course, your physician is always the best source of information about whether to be tested or not.
It's to add and expand on what Georgia said, for me personally, it was a very uplifting experience. Of course, I went through the depression piece of this, and went through feeling like life was at an end. To visit the and attend the prostate cancer meetings, it revitalized me. It gave me hope. And as George said, to meet men that have had every type of prostate cancer you can name. And the big plus, again for me, is that this is not a woe is me group. Mm-hmm. This group is full of life, and we're about living.
Good.
And a will to live. And so it encourages, I would say, it would encourage one to seek the questions. We hand out information such as our hot sheets. We encourage questions. We have question and answer periods in our meetings. Our meetings are open to the individual with prostate cancer as well as his spouse or partner, because it's a team. It's not just one person anymore. It's a team. And we wholeheartedly invite, you know, that group.
Yeah.
We also try to be an educational group. Mm-hmm. We spend some money. Our members are generous in assisting us in getting DVD presentations from national prostate cancer meetings with lots of good information, sometimes in greater detail than we really want. But it's an educational experience, which is extremely important in helping understand the disease. And we put out a monthly newsletter to let people know what's going on and what programs are gonna be held.
Okay.
And we also, he mentioned the hot sheet. The hot sheet is an Us Two publication of the latest monthly prostate cancer information from publications around the world, and even before it's published sometimes. And each member of the prostate cancer treating community in the Cape Fear area gets a copy of this personally delivered by me.
By you,
every month.
Mm-hmm.
And so we feel like that we're getting the best information out to the physicians and healthcare professionals who will be treating the men who will be watching this video.
All right. And we'll finish this up by just remembering that September is
Prostate Cancer Awareness Month.
And sounds like you have lots of information that folks can get access to if they need it. So thank you so much for coming and talking with me this afternoon.
Thank you for asking.
Thank you for having us.